Hey guys, this is Smithy. Welcome to my channel. If you guys are new here, welcome. Today's video, it's a full face of makeup that influencers made me buy it, or at least convinced me to buy it. So if you guys want to see how I achieved this look, and if you guys want to know who are the influencers that influenced me to buy all these makeup, then please keep on watching. Let's begin. I'm so excited. Let's begin with the brows. And the tinted brow pen that I'm going to use is NYX Professional Makeup Lift and Snatch Brow Tint Pen, and this was recommended by Andrea Matilano here on YouTube. She really has like beautiful brows, so I thought of like testing this out, and it just turned out perfectly because I am obsessed by this product, and I don't use that word very lightly. I really mean it. So I basically use this for like in the front of my brows, and it gives such like fine strokes which like mimics your hair, the brow hair, so nicely. And it's pretty much mistake proof. If you have like gone overboard, you can easily like blend it out with the spoolie, but it does give like hair like strokes. So as you can see, I just went like overboard here, but I can like take that off, but it's not going to move after it sets. Whenever I'm using this brow pen, I basically would love to like make a line underneath my brow just to clean up everything with like a normal brow pencil and then fluff it out with that brow pen. But after everything is done, I just take a spoolie and just run it through so that it's like evenly distributed. Just like that. So it gives very natural but more of a flushy but more of a fluffy lash look. So once that's done, let's move on to the primer. And the primer that I'm going to talk about is my Essence My Skin Tinted Perfector, and this was a product that was recommended by Mariam here on YouTube, Mariam Makilyaj. I think that's how you pronounce her last name. I'm pretty sure it's not her last name, but that's how her channel name is pronounced. So this product is more on like that mousse like texture, and it does have like a tint to it, which fills in the pores as well as like smoothens your texture. So I definitely love this primer really nicely. And especially if you do not have like much of things to like hide on your face, this can easily give you a good amount of tint. Also, I would say it would replace a very light coverage skin tint, but also perfect your skin at the same time. So I absolutely love these products. Now, all these products that I am using today are the products like which are my favorite, which I had bought because of the other influencers. So there's no doubt in if I like this or not, because I absolutely love all these products. So there's no doubt in that. Now the next product that I'm going to use is basically to cover my blemishes. And this is a product that was recommended here by Khaki here on YouTube. And this is Danessa Myrick's Vision Cover, and it is their foundation. I basically use this. I'll show you how much. I don't even know if you can see it or not, that much, because you need that amount of a product. And I take a flat shader brush, spread it out, and just put it right on my blemish areas, which is like my tough areas to hide from any concealer or foundation. And look at that tiny amount of product, how much it can cover. Like, blemish where, blemish who. By the way, I am in the shade N06 if you are my foundation twin, especially my tan shade. And I absolutely love this. Whatever is left in my hand, I'm just gonna run it underneath my brows just to clean it up a tiny little bit. And you need the tiniest bit. I'm pretty sure I've recommended this so many times on my channel, It is one of my favorite high coverage products, but you need to be very, very careful to apply very, very tiny little bit. You can also mix this with like a moisturizer just to give it more of that, you know, that liquidy foundation consistency, because it's a very thick foundation. Now for my normal foundation, I'm going to use my Catrice True Skin Foundation. And this, of course, everybody knows, was recommended by Tati here on YouTube. And that's when I got this. And I'm in the shade 046 Neutral Toffee. And this is more of that neutral tone foundation. I take one pump of it and I spread it all across my face. Now, because now I have targeted all my blemish areas, I won't need much of it. So this would be enough for whole of my face. So you in turn apply a lot less product. If you just hide your blemish areas or any imperfections on your face or hyperpigmentation. Absolutely love this foundation. As you can see, it gives a very skin-like finish, but it gives a good amount of coverage on your skin. So if you are looking for like a natural finish foundation, but which has like a medium buildable coverage, you would absolutely love this. This stays on for the entire day on my skin, and I am more of a combo oily skin, so you know, that's saying a lot. It doesn't like cake up or bunch up or put my oils through after the whole day is done. So I absolutely love this foundation. Now let's move on to the concealer, and I'm going to talk about my Milani Conceal and Perfect concealer. And this I am in the shade 145, and this is a little more on the deeper side. And this is the concealer that was recommended by Smitha Deepak here on YouTube. I kid you not, she only uses this concealer, and she has been here on the YouTube for a decade, I think. And she only uses this concealer, and that's why I really wanted to use this. Now I can definitely make this work, especially right now because I have a tan going on, but this definitely is not a brightening shade on me. It's a very my shade. So I'm gonna just apply tiny little bit like dots on my face and see how smoothly it blends. I'm gonna concentrate it in the inner corner of my eye and drag it across my eye area. I'm going to also apply this as my eye primer too, because the consistency is absolutely wonderful. And look how smoothening it is underneath the eyes. It doesn't cake up, it doesn't bunch up, and I absolutely adore this concealer. You can also spot conceal with this concealer if you do not want to invest on the Danessa Myricks one, but Danessa Myricks one is like a full coverage product. Now after that is done, I'm just quickly going to set my under eyes with my Belief Beauty powder, and this is a powder that was recommended by Emily Noel here on YouTube. Now if you guys are not following Emily, you are missing out. She is the sweetest person in this YouTube. I mean, she's been doing this for a long time. She has like a million subscribers, but she's so genuine, she's so down to earth. I just adore her. She's a mom of three, and I can totally relate to her. Just a sweetheart. And this powder is so beautiful, and this is like around $5. This is $5, I think, $4 or $5. But this is such a beautiful product. It smoothens out your texture. It sets your makeup for the entire day. It competes with all my high-end powders that I have in my collection. I absolutely love it. We are going to set the whole face with this, but before that, let me first finish off with my cream bronzer and the cream blush. Now, the cream bronzer that I'm going to talk about is M Cosmetics cream bronzer. And this is the product that Julia Adams uses it all the time. Not that because of her I bought it, because I bought this and reviewed this before she reviewed it. But she recommends this product a lot on the channel, and I wanted to use this. So here I am. So I'm just going to take this here, and you actually need a very tiny bit, because it's super pigmented, and this is in the shade Nomadic. I initially bought the shade Summer. If you had seen my review on this, you exactly know why I chose this shade, because Summer was basically my tan shade, so it didn't work out for me. So I'm going to take a stippling brush and you'll see how easily it can blend on the skin. Like, that's it. It just blends so beautifully, and just it blends into like a powdery finish, which is so beautiful. It gives like a very natural contoured bronzer kind of a look on the face, which I absolutely love. Now for the cream blush, I'm pretty sure you know what I'm going to use. I'm going to use my Doll 10 cream blush, and this is in the shade hashtag Doll Squad. And this is the product that Jen Phillips here on YouTube recommended this. I kid you not, I have not tested a cream blush in my collection which stands better than this. This is so buildable. This is so creamy. Again, mainly blends out into like a powdery finish, just like the M Cosmetics blushes. And it's so beautiful. I mean, you guys can see how easy it is to blend. And I'm using my e.l.f.'s stippling brush, the blush brush. I'm going to concentrate it on the outer, like, temple of my cheeks and on the apple of my cheeks. So, it's just so beautiful. The formula is stunning. If you guys have not tried this, give it a try and see. I'm a blush fanatic. I have so many cream blushes, powder blushes in my collection, and this just stands out like no other. It definitely sweeps away a lot of high-end blushes in my collection. Like, it just blows them out of the water. I love this one so, so, so much. And look at that shade. It's such a beautiful nudie pink mauvey shade. I love it. I'm going to now set using the same powder. Although you just don't need to set the face if you're using the cream products that I have used, especially if you are more on like the dry skin person. Now, because I'm an oily or a combo skin person, I generally do set my face all the time after applying all the cream products, just so that it doesn't like cake up or anything like that. And you need like the very light amount of powder just to set everything up. Now let's bronze up our skin. And for the bronzer, I'm going to use my Glowish bronzer. And this is the bronzer that Patty Alonso here on YouTube recommended. And I love this bronzer. It's a very sheeny bronzer, telling that it gives like a very skin-like effect on your face. So if you like that sheeny kind of a bronzer, not that it's like shimmery or anything, but it gives like a very satin finish on your face. I think the marbleized effect is what is making that satin finish. And this, by the way, I am in the shade 03 Tan Light. So this is basically like that third shade in the line. And they have quite a few shades and it goes pretty deep too. For that reason, I really, really like it. And it works beautifully on the skin. Is it like the best bronzer that I've ever tried? Not really. But do I like it? Yes, I do. Now it's time for highlighter. And the highlighter that I'm going to use is from Natasha Denona. And it is from the Diamond and Blush Face Palette. And this is a product that Ali Glines here on YouTube recommended. And this palette itself is amazing. I don't know whether you guys can find it or not, but the shades are absolutely stunning. So if you guys have not seen, it comes with three cream products and three powder products. So I am going to take the diamond powder here. It basically looks like wet on the skin, especially when you like buff it inside the skin, into the skin. It's so seamless and it's so beautiful. And especially if you do not want like that glittery effect on your skin, just tap off the excess, all the glitter will fall out and you will be left with like a beautiful sheen. I'm going to put a little bit of the other highlighter, the more of the bronzy tone one, on my nose and on my cupid's bow. Let's first set our face. I'm going to use my Milani Make It Last setting spray, which Kathleen Lights is the one who actually made me buy it, because she used to rave about this product back in the days and I have not stopped using this. So I'm going to use this. Now, once that is all set, let's move on to the eyes. I have two people to thank for this. The first person to thank is definitely Samantha March. And Samantha March is the one who really made me buy the Sigma Ambience palette and actually Corderosa palette. But Coralie is the one who gave me Corderosa palette. But yes, Samantha March is like my influence to get these palettes. And the second person that I have to thank is Mandy Lee here on YouTube. And she's the one who actually recommended Sydney Grace eyeshadows. And I absolutely love the quality of these shadows. So what I'm going to do, I actually don't know. But I am going to use both of these products. The Sigma palette as well as the Sydney Grace palette. And see what we come out with. So let's begin. So I'm first going to take the shade called Oasis from the Ambience palette and put that as my crease shade. And these shades are so pigmented, guys. It's just so pigmented. And I love Sigma's quality. There's no doubt about it. If you have been like a follower on my channel, you guys know how much I love my Sigma palettes, and I have three with me already. So yeah, I have the Warm Neutrals palette, I have the Corderosa palette, and I have the Ambience palette. But none of them has like disappointed me. Now, once we have that shade laid out, I'm gonna take my Sydney Grace shadow in the shade Adore Me, this mauvey shade, just because I feel like applying mauve today. And this is a beautiful, beautiful shade. I'm gonna apply that here. It's a very mauvey, rosy tone shade, which nowadays everybody's coming out with, like in Natasha Denona retro palette, the shade is there. The Pat McGrath shadow palette, the Utopian Dream palette, that has this shade. I mean, very much in the industry right now. I'm gonna apply the same shade in my lower lash line too. Now next, I'm gonna take the shade called Go For It from the palette. I have been waiting to use this shade on my eyes. And this is more of, I would say, a cool tone purple shade, but it also has that mauve undertone to it. So I'm gonna take that and apply that actually. Oh, stunning. Can you see that? Oh my God, that's stunning. I'm gonna concentrate that on the center of my eyelid and move on to the outer corner. And I'm actually applying this with my small blend brush from a Praktiki line from Sigma. I love that. Look at the dimension. That's stunning. I also want to point out, if you are applying it wet is when you'll get that texture on your eyes, if you like that textural look. But if you apply it dry, it's a very smooth shadow. Now, for my inner corner, I am gonna actually take this shade, which is called The Greatest Gift from Sydney Grace. This is another shadow that I wanted to apply this for such a long time. And this is more of like a green to a purple flip shadow. But I think the beauty of this shadow will only come when you apply it like all over your eyelid. Because that's when you can like see the shift happening with this shadow. I'm just gonna layer it on top of that purpley shade, not completely, but I would say like halfway through, so that it can melt with each other. And then I'm gonna dip into the shade called Summer Solstice from this palette. Whoops. And I'm gonna take that on my lower lash line. It's more of that rosy brown kind of a shade, which would absolutely go wonderful with this eyeshadow. And then I'm going to dip into this shade from Sydney Grace, which is called Choco Raspberry Fudge. And it's that deep brown shade, but also with like a red undertone to it. So it'll go very nicely with this eye look. I'm just going to deepen up the outer corner with it. So I just finished off my eyes by applying some liner, and I just use my Wet n Wild Mega Liner because I do not have any recommendation and I use the same three eyeliners every day. So let's move on. I also lined my lips with a brown liner, and this is KKW's Nude 2.5 liner, that lip liner that I applied. Now let's move on to the lipstick, and this is a lipstick that was recommended by Julia Adams here on YouTube again, and this is M Cosmetics Lip Cushion, and this one particularly is in the shade Venetian Rose. Now I love this, I love all of this, but this especially, like, this formula is so nourishing on the lips. That's just stunning. Look at the amount of shine it gives. It's so beautiful. It's lovely. I actually do not need it, but I do have a lip gloss recommendation also here, and this one is from Tower 28, and this is the one that was recommended by Jamie Page here on YouTube. She's big on Tower 28 lip glosses, so am I. I'm big on Tower 28 in general, but she's the one who recommended the shade called Cashew. I do have Cashew, but I want to give it more of a pinky tint, so I'm going to use Coconut today. These are very sheer lip glosses, so yeah, there's nothing to worry. Look at that. Love it. I absolutely love it. Now for the final step, my camera got cut off, but I only finished off with my last step, and that's mascara. And the mascara that I'm going to talk about is my L'Oreal Lash Paradise mascara, and this was recommended by Tati several years before when it came. And I cannot thank her enough, because this is like my go-to mascara in my routine. You guys know, every time I do my makeup, I am using this mascara. And that is what I have on my eyes right now. So I'm just going to quickly curl my lashes and finish off this eye look. And curling after applying mascara makes like the biggest difference, as you guys can see. And that is my final look. I really hope that you guys enjoyed this tutorial and you loved all the recommendations that I showed to you, which were my favorite out of the influencers who recommended this product to me. And if you did like this, do not forget to give me a thumbs up, because it really makes my day. And also subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and ring that notification bell so that you're notified every time that I post next. I generally upload every Tuesdays, Thursdays and Saturdays at 9 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Until next time, I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!